My name is Simone Giertz, and I am an inventor.
I uploaded my first robot on YouTube in 2015, and it was a toothbrush helmet. So it was a skateboard helmet, and it had a robot arm and a toothbrush on it. Then I made an alarm clock that slaps me in the face to wake me up, a robot that put lipstick on me, a soup robot that served me soup, and a lot of other machines of varying quality and entertainment value.
I came to be known as the queen of robots. I had so much fun building useless machines, and to me it was really a way for me to learn about electronics without having like my performance anxiety get in the way. Because if you set out to build something that's gonna fail, like that definitely gives you a lot of freedom. Then like as I gained more and more skills, I kind of just wanted to start building useful things. And initially it was just something I did on the side, like not on my YouTube channel, because I was like, no, I need to build like shitty robots. Every machine needs to have a punchline. My audience is never gonna be down for this. And then I had a brain tumor.
So I'm gonna have to have pretty extensive brain surgery, and I'm probably gonna be out for a while.
And then you kind of like lose to give. So I was like, I'm just gonna start building these very normal-ish projects and make videos out of them because it was what I wanted to do. So I converted a Tesla into a pickup truck and named her Truckla. I really need a pickup truck for the work I do. Like I'm always hauling plywood and steel stock and tools, and there just were not any good electric pickup trucks on the market. It took about a year of planning. Like it was a year from having the idea and then my team and I just planning everything out and trying to do research and make sure that it was feasible before we put an angle grinder to a car. And then the actual work ended up only being about a month. The team and I were working restlessly to get it done on time. Tesla was starting to gear up to release the Cybertruck, and I really wanted to release mine before them. I was nervous about how it was going to be received in the car world because, like, it's a world that I don't know much about and that I know people don't know much about me either. But people were really sweet about it. Like, I still get the occasional thumbs down on the freeway, and I'm like, I see you there in your Ford F-150. I appreciate your opinion, but f you right back. So there's a staircase and then there's a little seat. And I also added this little nook where my footrest is. So she has two beds.
I've been working a lot on my product company. So that's kind of my big goal for the future, is running an innovation house. And I really just want to prototype products and invent real things and be able to throw sketches over to teams of engineers and be like, let's see if this could be a thing. Like that's what I'm working towards, and that's been taking up a lot of my time and something that we're spooling up to launch soon, which I'm really excited about. It definitely feels like a new chapter.
The thing about like making videos on the internet is, and over such a long time, is that it kind of needs to follow your life. If you like want to do something that feels genuine and it's actually you in the videos, not like a character you're playing, like it will evolve as you evolve as a person. If I wake up one morning and I'm like, I never want to build another robot, I never want to make another video, like that's okay. Like I really don't want to play a role of my life or like who I am or the things I'm doing. Like I genuinely want to do the things I'm excited about. And that means that sometimes there's going to be curveballs and things that like my audience might not be down for, and that's okay. I'm trying not to make things for the algorithm.
I promise this is not like a shtick I do. It just genuinely never fucking works.
Cut.